And that evacuation of government employees from Iraq raises concerns about Christians left behind. The Trump administration says it remains committed to persecuted Christians in the Middle East. Vice President Mike Pence addressed that issue today. White House correspondent Mark Irons reports. Good evening, Mark.
Good evening, Lauren. The vice president's office tells me a government official overseeing aid to minority communities, including Christians in Iraq, will remain despite the withdrawal of U.S. personnel. Still, questions remain about the faithful living in the birthplace of Christianity.
There's concern for Christian communities in the Middle East after the U.S. State Department decided to evacuate all non-emergency U.S. government employees from Iraq. White House Press Secretary Sarah Sanders gives her reaction to News Nightly.
Certainly we hope that this isn't long term or something that lasts an extensive amount of time, and that the tensions there will ease and those individuals will return back and return back to their work.
The Trump administration made the decision to pull out personnel as U.S. tension escalates with Iran, Iraq's neighbor. Tofiq Baklini, a leading voice for Middle East Christians, hopes the U.S. will still provide support.
Keep the U.S. Government and the Pentagon involved, and to have it should be a safe area, a safe zone, protected by air.
And in Iraq, Catholic Archbishop Bashar Warda says the 2011 U.S. pullout from Iraq created a vacuum, allowing ISIS to emerge. He urgently writes a new vacuum created by American disengagement will likely meet with a similarly unhappy result. In 2016, then-Secretary of State John Kerry admitted a genocide targeting religious groups was being carried out by ISIS, also referred to as Daesh.
In my judgment, Daesh is responsible for genocide against groups in areas under its control, including Yazidis, Christians, and Shia Muslims.
And now, even though ISIS has lost control of the territory, Christians stand in the rubble in a region known as the birthplace of their faith.
In many areas in Iraq, they still speak the Aramaic language. It's the original language of Christ. This is where it all began.
Lauren, a Trump administration official, tells me today's meeting led by the vice president would convey the U.S. commitment to minority communities, including Christians in Iraq, despite the security threat posed by Iran. At this point, it's not clear when U.S. personnel would be allowed back into the country. Lauren.